Namaste students, hope you all fine. Myself Saranya, I am your EVS teacher. Today we are going to see the lesson number 19. A seed tells a farmer story. So children, in this lesson one seed is telling the farmer story. Shall we hear what the seed is going to say? Come, let's see. I am a small seed. I am a small bajra seed. So, do you know which seed it is? Look at the picture here. So, this seed is called bajra. I have stayed in this beautiful wooden box since 1940. I want to tell you my story. This is a long story, but not mine alone. It is also the story of my farmer Damji Bai and his family. If I do not tell my story now, it might be too late. So children, this bajra seed is going to tell the story of this seed and the farmer who is having this seed in the wooden box, whose name was Damji Bai. Okay children, so this Damji Bai, how he is preserving the seed, what happened to the seed, what happened to his family, like that we are going to see in the story. Okay children, I was born in Vangam in Gujarat. That year there was a good bajra, that is millet crop. There was a festive mood in the village. So usually you can hear that whenever the crops are ready to the harvest in the village, they all will celebrate that. So it will be in a festive mood. Our area was famous for its grain and vegetables. Each year Damji Bai kept aside some seeds from a good crop. So always while harvesting, he will be keeping some of the seeds. He will be preserving some of the seeds in the wooden box. So you can see here children, the wooden box is here. Like this, he will be preserving that. This way, our bajra family went on from one generation to another. So why they are keeping like this means to seeding it again. So only one small part of the bajra will be saving for the next generation, like next harvesting. So it is like seeds for next time. Good seeds were stored in a dried gourd, that is loki, which was coated with mud. So you can see here the picture. So like this, in this pot they will be preserving that. But that year Damji Bai himself made a strong wooden box to store us. So the wooden box you can see in this picture. So he made this box which were very strong. He put a neem leaves. Children, you can see in this picture, right? Some neem leaves are there. So can you see that? Wait, I'll show you that. So in this picture, they have kept and they have put some neem leaves. Why they are putting neem leaves means to prevent that from insects. So to prevent that from insects, they put neem leaf. He put different seeds in different compartments of the box. That was our beautiful home. So like this, whatever they have harvested, the Damji Bai will keep some seeds in the different types of wooden box. So it is the home for the seeds. In those days, Damji Bai and his cousins lived together. So it's like a joint family.
It was a large family. Everyone in the village helped each other, even in farming. So, in the village also, all the peoples are helping each other, even in farming. When the crop was ready and harvested, everyone celebrated together. Oh, those wonderful days, with a big feast and lots to eat. I told you before, right, children? When the crop is ready for the harvest, the village peoples will celebrate that. It will be a celebrating mode they will be having. It will be very nice. In the winter, it could be time to enjoy the undia. Undia means a kind of stew. All the vegetables were put into a clay pot. So, all the vegetables they will be putting into the pot along with fresh spices. The pot was sealed and kept between hot coals. The vegetables cooked slowly in this special cooker. So, this in those times cooker and all was not there, right? So, they will be cooking this in the clay pot only. Above, they will be sealing it. Like some plates they will be keeping or they will be sealing that. So in that special cooker, all the vegetables are slowly cooked on the fields. Oh, I forgot the pot was placed upside down. That is why the dish was called undia. So you can see here, children, how they are keeping. It was upside down. So, undia or upside down in Gujarati. Undia would be eaten with bajra rotis. So, for this too, they will be having bajra rotis, which is freshly cooked on the chula. Chula means that also one type of earthy tawa. Oh, what an earthy, delicious flavor. So, while cooking in the earthy things like pot and chulka, that and all, you will be having some taste of that soil, that earthy smell also will be there. The aroma will be like that. It will be very good for health. So, that also there in the flavor. Along with that, homemade butter, curd and buttermilk was served. So, see how many dishes they have prepared for this celebration. Farmers would grow many different kinds of crops. So, the farmers will grow many types of crops, grains and vegetables. According to the season, the farmers kept enough for their needs and sold the rest to shopkeeper from the city. Some farmers also grew cotton at home. Family members. So, children, during that season, they will be, what type of season is there? So, along with that season, they will be growing grains and vegetables. And some of the farmers will grow cotton also. And in the family members, they will be spun the cotton. Spun means, you look at the picture. Like this, they will be doing that cotton. On a charak. Charak means the spinning wheel to make a cloth. So, using the spinning wheel, they will be making the cotton into the cloth. So, like this, the family members also will help. So, tell. Are rotis made in your home? From which grain are they made? So, in your home, roti is you are making means what type of grain they are using. And have you eat the roti made from bajra or jowar? Did you like this? So, this is your homework, children. So, observe in your home and write this answer. Okay, children. Next, find out and write. In your house, what is done to protect grains and pulses from insects? What our mothers will do? So, to protect these types of grains and pulses from insects. My mother keeps grains and pulses in a airtight container. So in the airtight container, no insects can be gone inside, right? Sometimes she dries them in the sun. So they will be keeping it in the sunshade, so that if any insects are there, means it will be go away. Which are the different festivals related to farming celebrated in different seasons? Find out more about any one such festival and write in your notebook. So children, you have to observe in your village sites, or did you heard about any festivals regarding farming? So you can observe that and you can write the answer for this. Like, what is the name of the festival, which season they will be celebrating, and which state is there, and what special foods they are preparing for that, and why they are celebrating, and the peoples are celebrating in the family members all only or with the many peoples. So observe this and write your answer. This is your homework. And talk to the elders in your family and find out if there were some special foods cooked earlier that are not cooked anymore. So most of the, like this in our home, I'm telling about my home, so you can ask your elders and write your answer. In our home, we will be making laddus and all in those days, but now we are getting it from the shops. So like that, ask your elders what type of foods they are making earlier, but not now they are not cooking it, they are getting from outside. So what type of that? Write your answer. So next thing, find out about the crops, cereals, vegetables, pulses that are grown in your area. Of those, is there anything that is famous across the country? So children, this is your homework. You have to write what type of crops or cereals or pulses, you can take whatever, but in your area which is famous, and in your country which is famous that. So we are all in India, right? So you can write the India's famous thing and all. So that things you can write. And children, see here they have given four types of grains. So you can identify this also and write their names below. Okay children, this is also your homework. Next, when the times changed, over the years many changes took place in the village. So after the time change, the village also become developed, right? So there will be many changes in the villages also. Some places could get water from the canal. Canal means, you can see in this picture children, it's this picture is called canal. So in the some of the village sites, they will be getting water from this. They said the canal brought water from the far away, where a dam had been built on a big river. So this river is coming from the dam. Then electricity came, switch on the button, and there was a light. So those days light and all will not be there. So after times changes, switch on the light will be there. So like that, people found that only one or two crops like wheat and cotton got better prices in the market. So after times, only two types of crops got very better price in the market. So most of the farmers began to grow only these. So if the profit is not there, means they will not grow that crop, right children? So this is a basic thing. So like that, many of the crops was destroyed, like no one is growing that. Soon we old friends like bajra and jowar and also vegetables were forgotten and dismissed. So this bajra gets very upset. So no one is growing me, so we are forgotten and dismissed even from Damji buys fields. Farmer even began to buy seeds from the market. So, in those days, what Damji Bhai will do? He will be storing some seeds for growing, right? After the time change, they are buying seeds from outside market. People said there were new kinds of seeds. So, farmers did not need to store seeds from the old crop. So, they forgot about storing the crops also. Now, people in the village cooked and ate together only on very special days. As they ate, they would remember how tasty the food used to be in the past, fresh from the fields. When the seeds have changed, how could food ever taste the same? So, you can observe. If you're in your home, you're having a small garden. If you're planting some tomatoes, chilies, or small types of small vegetables you're using, like coriander, mentia. So, like that, you are planting means if you're taking directly from your plant and if you cook, that means that will be a different fresh taste. You can observe that. And you can compare with the taste which we are buying outside. So, it is totally different because they are using too much of chemical fertilizers and insect. For fertilizer, they are using chemicals for avoiding the insects to come. So, these things will affect the natural proteins from the vegetables. So, that's why the freshness will got gone. Damji boy was getting old. His son Hasmukh looked after the fields and the family. So, after Damji boy, his son came and he was maintaining the field and the family. He was making a lot of money from farming. So, after he was taking care of the field, he was getting more money in that. He rebuilt the old house. He brought a new machine for farming. He used electrical motor to pump water. And he bought a new motorcycle. So, which they can be go to the city easily. And also the tractor to pluck the fields. Usually in the fields, what is used to pluck the field? Bullocks, right, children? So, after they bought the tractor, bullock also went. They did not use that. They are using tractors. So many new things they have bought for the farming. Hasmukh would say, "Now we are farming wisely. We grow only what we can sell in the market at a good price. With profits from our fields, we can improve our life. We can make progress." So, what he is saying means, like wisely we are farming. I can get more money because I am growing only the crops which I can get profit in the market. So, only some type of crops he is growing, which is having a great profit in the market. So, lying forgotten in the wooden box. So, he forgot about the wooden box. I and other seeds had our doubts. So, job, this Bajra and other seeds was in the doubt. Is all these really progress? There is no longer any need for seeds like us and animals like the bullocks. After the tractor has came, even the people who worked on the fields were no longer needed. How will they earn money? What will they live on? So the seeds are asking question. We are not useful to us. So you are not using us. After coming the tractor, even bullocks are not using. So if the tractor is there, if the farming machine is there, means the workers also will be less, right? So how they will be earning money? So everything was collapsed. More and more expenses. The next 20 years saw even more changes. So after 20 years also, there will be more changes. More updates will be came, right? Without cows and buffaloes, there was no cow dung to be used in the field as fertilizer. So in the olden days, they will be using fertilizer only with the cow dung and buffalo's dung only. They will be using as a fertilizer. After the time changes, they are buying expensive fertilizer outside. A new kinds of seeds were such that crops were easily affected by harmful insects. So they are getting seeds from outside. Easily the seeds will get infected from the insects. So for that they will be spraying medicines to keep the crops away from insects. Oh, what a bad smell this had and how expensive they were. So see, if they are using the old thing, means everything was fresh and everything was in the cheap, but they are expensive more and more and they are getting not a fresh crops. They are eating a medicines. So like that, the canal water was not enough for the new crops. So the new crops are wanting a more water. For that, the canal water was not enough. All the farmers used pumps to lift the water from deep under the ground. So if think children, if we all are digging water from the ground, means how the underground water will be there? Without underground water, how the crops can grow? So everyone should think of this. To meet all these expenses, loans had to be taken from the bank. So after all these things, they are taking on loans in the bank. Whatever little profit was made was used to repay the loan. So whatever profit they are getting, they have to pay for the loan in the bank. So this case has happened. But there was little profit. Everyone was growing cotton. So after this, everyone started growing cotton. So the cotton price were not as high as before. So if everyone is growing cotton, means how the price of the cotton will increase? It will be decreased only, right children? So it will be, the price also was very less. The soil itself was no longer the same. Growing the same crop and over using so many chemicals had affected the soil so much that now nothing could grow well there. So in the field of land, if we are growing same type of crops again and again by using chemical fertilizers, by spraying medicines, like this we are doing, means the earth will be dried up. It will not give the proteins which we are getting. So after that, we can't grow anything in that land. So the land also get affected. It was becoming very difficult to earn money for living by farming alone. So the farming was very difficult after that. Hamsa too changed the with the times. He is often tense and angry most of the time. So after all these happens, means the person will be in a peaceful life? Not at all. So he was tensed and he was getting anger for everything. By seeing him, his educated son Prakash did not want to do farming. So after seeing all these things, anyone could interested to do farming? No. Like that, his son also now started work as a truck driver. After all the bank loans settled, had to be repaid, often Prakash doesn't came home for days. At times, he is away for a week. 2 days back, When he came home, Prahash started looking for something. "Ba," he said, "his mother, where is Dadaji's wooden seed box? It will be useful to keep the screws and tools for the truck." Now, do you understand why I told you my story? So see how they become. After all these happen, they are looking for the wooden box to keep the tools for the trucks. Even they didn't look up that seeds. They forgotten everything. So if they took that seeds, it will be more helpful for them. But they have forgotten that. They have remember only that wooden box. So this is your project work, children. What question came to your mind about farmers and farming? Write some questions in your group and ask a farmer. For example, how many crops do they grow in a year? Which crop needs how much water? So children, if you know any farmer like your relatives or neighborhood, so you can ask question about this and you can form one report, like writing the question and getting answer from them. And you can visit the farm near your area, observe and talk to the people there. Write a report. So this is your report you have to do, children. A journey of bajra seed from a field to a plate. So how the bajra seed was, we are going to see the journey, how the bajra seed was taken to the plate as a food. What can you see in each picture on the next page? So in the next page, I am going to show you some steps. For that, what and all the process have been taken place, we are going to see there. What technology could have been used to cut the stem in the picture one? So like that, we are going to see there. And you can write it in your own also. I'm going to say the step one to the step nine. So you can see in this picture, children, the first step, they are cutting down the stems, right? So what is the first step means? A lady is separating and taking out the comb from the bajra crop. So the bajra, it will be in the stem. After that, in the second picture, the bajra comb is kept in a mortar. So like this, they will be keeping it. It will be pounded by a pestle to separate the grains from the combs. Pounded means like digging. While digging, it will be separated. The seeds will be separated. So third picture, bajra seeds are kept in a plate. So after that process, we will be getting bajra seed. The fourth picture was showing that a lady is grinding bajra seeds to make a flour. She is using chakki, that is grinding stone, for that. So you can see in this picture, children, this is chakki, where in this hole they will be putting the seeds and they will be holding this stick and they will be rotating that. So after that, they will be getting bajra flour. So in the fifth picture, they have kept it in a plate, that bajra flour. And sixth picture, dough has been made from bajra flour. How we are making dough for chapati and all, right? So like that, they have made. Seventh picture, chapati is being made from the dough. So they are using only hand. Now we are using some plates and roller, right? So in those days, they are doing in the hand. So eighth picture, chapati is being cooked on the tawa. And the ninth picture is chapati is kept in a plate. So this is the journey of bajra seeds to coming to the plate. So how many process they are doing? It's a very big process, right, children? So like this they are doing. So children, hope you understand about the farming in this lesson. Read the lesson thoroughly and do your homework and do your activity, that is a project report. Do that and send it in the group. Okay, children. Thank you.